Hello everyone. Today we're going to talk about some of the more advanced features on the Hunter Road Force Elite Balancer, namely the road force measurement and the force matching procedure. But first, what is road force? Road force is essentially a measurement of the tire and wheel uniformity as a combination together as one unit. The road force balancer actually simulates driving conditions like the weight of the vehicle on the tire and wheel while in motion. Okay, so we can use this to correct any sort of vibration that comes up that's not related to the actual tire wheel balance. And we're going to do that through the force matching procedure, which we'll show you how to do now. So we'll go ahead and mount our tire and wheel up to the balancer like normal. And once we've done that, it's just a matter of dropping the hood. The balancer is going to go ahead and measure the balance of the tire and wheel assembly, and then we'll go ahead and drop our load roller on the rear of the machine, which is going to simulate that road test and look at our road force measurement on the entire assembly. Okay, so you can see here on the screen on the bottom left hand side, we actually have a road force measurement with this tire and wheel assembly of 19 pounds. It's also giving us a prediction as far as the corrected road force of 12 pounds. So to correct that, we can go through our force match process, which is going to ask me to do a couple different things. So it's going to actually ask me to mark the tire in a particular location and then mark the rim in another particular location. And once I've identified those two locations, I can take the tire wheel off of the balancer and take that over to my tire machine and actually clock the tire on the wheel to match those two marks together. And in that case, once we air up the tire and put it back on the machine, we should get a corrected road force value of about that 12 pound mark. So we'll go ahead and do that now. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is mark our tire up here on the top of the rim. So what's nice with the balancer is it actually brought the tire wheel around to the position where it's gonna bring that spot up to top dead center. So I can mark that on the sidewall here. And then I can servo the tire around, and the balancer is going to bring that spot on the rim, the top dead center, for me as well. So I can make a mark there. Okay, and then at this point I can go ahead and take the tire and wheel off the balancer and take that over to my tire machine. Okay, so once the beads are loosened, I've got the tire properly lubricated, I can go ahead and actually bring my rollers down just a little bit more to put a little bit more tension on the tire. And then I'll come over to my rotation pedal and I'll go ahead and just slowly rotate the tire. And what you see is what will start happening is the rim will start spinning independent of the tire. So we go ahead and identify where our marks are at. So we got our mark here on the tire, mark here on the rim. And we'll go ahead and bring those two around so they're clocked together. Looks like right about there, it's going to be pretty good. Okay. So once I'm happy with that, I can go ahead and air my tire back up. Go ahead and grab my valve core here. Go ahead and insert my valve core. So now that we've reinflated our tire and reinserted our valve core into the valve stem, we're going to perform a process called bead massage. This is an automatic process featured on our Revolution tire changer that's going to allow us to make sure that the tire is seated properly on the rim. This will give us the lowest road force results and make our road force predictions on the balancer more accurate. So let me show you how that works. So on the screen, I'll go ahead and select bead massage, and we'll just have to step on the go pedal one time. And the tire changer is going to go ahead and run this automatic process. So what you'll see is the rollers come in and contact the tire. It's going to put a little bit of pressure on the sidewall of the tire. And what that does is kind of flex the bead on the tire to make sure it's fully seated into the bead seat on the tire and wheel. So this process is really going to make sure that that mounting uniformity is correct throughout the entire mating surface on the rim, just to really make sure that this tire is seated correctly all the way around so it's as round as possible. So that process is finished, so let's go ahead and take the tire off the tire changer and let's take it back over to the balancer. Okay, so we'll go ahead and put our tire wheel back on the balancer. Okay, we'll just make sure that our inflation pressure, when performing a road force measurement, the tire should be inflated to the PSI specified on the vehicle placard to ensure that we get an accurate road force reading on the balancer. Okay, at this point, I can go ahead and click verification spin. So now that we've got our tire and wheel assembly back up on the balancer, we'll go ahead and drop the hood and do our verification spin. So I'll go ahead and hit verification spin up here on the screen, and we can bypass this. So the balancer is going to go ahead and do a balance spin for us, and then it's going to drop the load roller to measure our road force. Okay, so this is exactly what we were hoping for. So with our road force measurement, we actually reduced that road force value by almost half. We're actually down to 11 pounds now versus where we were at previously. So at this point, I'm happy with my road force values. So I can come over here to our balance screen. So we'll go ahead and grab our 3/4 of an ounce of weight, and we'll go ahead and servo the tire around to bottom dead center. And we'll go ahead and place our weights in the correct spot. So the balancer is nice. It's going to light up a laser for me down there on the rim, so I know exactly where to put it. At that point, we can go ahead and drop our hood and do our check spin. We'll go ahead and check the balance, make sure we balance out okay. And there we go, we have okay on the screen. So that's the force match procedure. So to recap, what we did was we took our tire and wheel assembly off of the vehicle, we placed that on the balancer, we measured road force with the load roller on the back of the machine, we identified where our stiff spots were and marked those on the tire and on the rim, and we took our assembly over to the tire changer and actually clocked those two positions together, brought the tire and wheel back over to the balancer, remeasured our road force, and actually reduced our road force value by almost half by that simple process. Also, tagging along with that, we were able to balance the tire as well after that process to guarantee that we are going to have a much gentler riding assembly for the customer back on the vehicle. So that's the process. Very simple, very easy to use. Thanks for watching.